everybody. Welcome to our Saturday Switch Play Monkey Secret Poncho stream. We have Chris and Yusuf today. Yusuf is back. Say hi, everybody.
Hey. Can't hear you.
Yeah.
Did you mute your mic, Yus?
Yeah. There we go. Hey, everybody.
Hey.
How's your sleep, Tony?
Good. It's sleeping.
Chris, you switched the wolf up with Kid Red, hey?
Yeah. I had to get something out of my storage locker, and I flipped the tubes over, and now it's on Kid Red's side, so...
Nice. There you have it. Cool. Can you move your head for a sec? Oh, man, look at that one.
Mm-hmm. Ta-da!
That was our banner at PAX. Yeah, Chris uses it now for his wall art in his home.
Bras of Steel says Yus looks 100% done.
Yeah, I'm in a different location on a different computer, so I'm not really sure how to make this look good. Done like dead?
Or done know. As in looking good.
I don't, never heard, I assume that's what he means, though. Alright, I'm going to just log in Twitch here and say hi to everybody. So who do we have in the stream?
We have Arenas, Browse of Steel, Jin, Nicholas TV, DRB Good.
Awesome. It's a good crew.
So, all right, so last week we kind of went and talked about the three to play ideas, just the fact we're doing it. We didn't really go into detail because you're not here. So if the people that are watching right now have any questions that I couldn't answer last week, now is a good time to ask Yus.
Yeah, I mean, I'll tell you guys, usually how this stuff works is companies don't announce anything until they're 100% settled, because once they say stuff, they're stuck, man. Like, people get it in their head and they get super mad if it deviates from that or something. So what we just want to say is we want to be transparent with you guys to tell you what we're thinking and give you our thought process right now. We don't have everything worked out. So something might come up where we realize, like, oh, that's actually a bad idea what we were thinking. But there's a benefit we want to share with you guys, because you can give us some input and stuff like that too. So we're going to be transparent at risk of being uncorporate, like, you know, risk some corporate safety and just be transparent, like a bunch of dudes that want to share our ideas with you guys. Yeah, so the biggest idea is free to play. You know, it just seems like a barrier to get people in the game has been a price, because almost all multiplayer-only games are free now. And we've always been scared of free-to-play because it's kind of creepy, you know? So we decided, okay, let's look at free-to-play and if we can do it in a classy way. And there's a few games that do it pretty good. Like, I think that the PC mobile games do it pretty good. There's no pay-to-win in there. And that's the main thing we want to avoid. We also want to make sure that we put in a model where when we started looking into free-to-play, like how it works, it kind of works like 95% of your people don't buy anything, and then 5% of your people want to buy stuff. So you have to have enough stuff for them to be able to fund your game. And that's the tricky thing, is like we don't really have enough products in our game for a free-to-play model to work. So that's something we've been looking at, analyzing, well, how do we do that? It sucks, because if the numbers were like, you know, 25% of the people buy stuff or 50% of the people buy stuff, then it changes the model. You can get away with a totally different model. But if the way free to play works, it's a little bit scary. So we're kind of learning those ropes right now before we kind of make any final decisions. But we think we came up with a good system, and we sort of have a few goals when we do free to play. One, you know, the reason we're doing free-to-play is that we want to bring in players. That's the biggest goal, right? So number two, we want to do it in a way that's not creepy. And that means no, we don't want to do any pay-to-win kind of stuff. So that makes it a little bit harder for us, because that's an easy way around, you know, when people are like, oh, we want to get the 5% to pay. Well, that's how they do it. They could give them like special items and make them tougher and all that stuff, but we don't want to do that. So so rule number two, goal number two is we want to not do any pay to win. Goal number three, we want to come up with a system that's really fair to people that already bought the game, so that there's a difference between, I mean, I know you guys are really cool and you just want to see players, but we still want you guys to have some extra value for buying the game when and supporting us early. And goal number four is we want it to be successful so that we don't just set it free to play and then have to go and move on to other things. We want to set it up so that the model is successful enough that if there is revenue coming in, that we can continue to support the game and continue expanding it, because that would be our goal. So, yeah, so that's basically it. That's what do you guys think of that set of goals, first of all? Chris, Tony, do you guys agree?
We talk about it a lot, so definitely agree. We put up a lot of energy and time into just entertaining the idea like a few months ago, way before the free week, and now it's like we have an idea what we want like for it to be, and it's just I think we totally agree. So
when we say we want to keep it classy, free to play, and we're investigating how to do classy, though, that's what we mean is how do we achieve those four goals. And those are a good set of goals. I would be comfortable with a free to play game if it could achieve those four goals. And yeah, and we've always been a little bit gun shy because we've been kind of creeped out by a lot of pay to win stuff. You know, I like the old model. I wish the old model still worked, where you just make a fighting game and you sell it and it has all your characters in it, and maybe you can sell some skins or something, but. I think it's a different generation now. You're going to even see fighting games like probably Rising Thunder and stuff all being free to play. And so I guess that's the way it is, so we'll adapt. So the first thing we did was we looked at like our products, and we're like, okay, well, what happens if we, you know, like Browse is saying, selling some outlaws and skins. And so we looked at that, and we kind of measured it out. We're like, oh crap, this model wouldn't work just because we don't have enough characters and skins. I think if we had like 40 characters and they each had like 3 skins or something, it could work out. But then we started looking at some other stuff that's not pay to win stuff, like, and we started looking at, well, weapon skins that are just aesthetic, and can we do taunt animations, and can we do alternate, you know, victory animations that you could just like have a really cool victory animation that plays when you win. So those are the stuff we're looking at. We have to build a lot. There's a lot of stuff to build, but that's kind of along the lines we're going.
You know what's really funny that I noticed, that we were when we have the game, like, you know, the full game release, we were thinking about how to be like almost like how do we give everybody everything right off the bat, and it seems like when we're thinking about like the player, they feel like once they get everything, there's not as much of a goal to unlock things anymore. So when we start talking about the free to play idea, a lot of the stuff we talk about is like, oh, how do we make people want to keep playing now the game is for free, right? Because a lot of people can't just pick it up and go, I experience everything. And then they're done with it, right? So it's interesting how by giving too much away when we were, it actually end up like kind of making the game not as they feel like there's less content by giving them more content in the beginning.
Yeah, you want people to. I guess you just want to pace it out with and give tease them a little bit with content. We found also that with free to play. In our kind of research, there's like a different mentality with free-to-play players that you download the game. When you guys buy the game, you look at the store page and you make a decision. Am I going to commit to this game? And then if you like it enough, you know, you put in your credit card in Steam and you buy a $15 game, and then it's yours. So now you're invested in the game and you want it to be good and you're going to play it. What we found is there's a difference with a free-to-play mindset, because people just kind of grab it, but they're not invested in it at all. And so if something just bugs them in the first like 30 seconds, they're like, screw it, this game's stupid, you know, and it's really easy to lose them. And a game with a high skill base and stuff runs a lot of risks for that kind of stuff. So that those are some other things that we've been carefully considering. Even things like, you know, making them feel rewarded. Like, our game's going to be hard, so we have to kind of make them feel good, even if they lose a match, their first match or whatever. So we're looking at that kind of stuff, because that stuff makes a huge difference for a successful, I mean, a game that if it can, like, if like 10% of the people that try the game end up being like, okay, I'm going to stick around for a second match, that's way different than if only 2% do. So we're also looking at ways to kind of make it more rewarding in the first experiences for the player. So anyways, should we jump in some games? So we can also ask, people can ask questions along the way. We don't want to do too much talking.
I've invited Chris and we started the search.
Awesome.
You can ask
the fight questions. Us.
Or fight us, yes.
So Arenas is asking if I read his post. Arenas, I've been super, super slammed, but I did see your post, and I flagged it that I'm going to come back, circle to it later, and do a response. It was a very big post, so it was a lot there. I wanted to kind of go through it slow and not rush it. But yeah, we've been getting a lot of... Actually, I've been polling people, so Arenas too, we can also chat anytime. I've been kind of like randomly pinging people to poll our community, and just... Because we know as players what we think of free-to-play games and what we think is cool and not cool. But it's also good to just sort of, we just sort of spot check with our community that we trust and just ask them sometimes their thoughts. But if anyone's worried about, I mean, there's different ends of free-to-play. There's the creepy side. And then there's just like a side where a game is exactly the same, but it's just free. You know, we're trying to figure out where in that spectrum do we go.
I can't believe that missed.
Chris. He's executing. Ah!
Oh, I didn't see.
My fault. I thought you weren't, you didn't have two on you, so. Right,
coming.
Ready.
Chop her down.
Yeah, she has no stamina. She has to hide.
Ah, they healed. What happened there?
I ran out of weapons. I threw them all.
Voice of all is asking why can killer use mind control. So we actually don't have magic in the game. The way that we sort of justify the knife, and it is a little bit of a stretch, but killer is a skilled guy and he can put some spin in the knife. In the beginning, and that's kind of how he banks it, but it does seem a little bit like mind control because he changes it mid direction, but we're cheating a little bit.
Yeah, I died.
I'm coming to you.
Can you come?
Right. Yeah.
Umbri the Umbreon is asking, are we going to change Killer's knife so it has a cooldown before it will stun again? So Killer's knife, every move in this game has a penalty. I'm assuming you mean for the melee slash. Killer's knife actually costs a stamina unit to do. So that's why he doesn't have a cooldown. Whereas Kid Red's doesn't have a stamina. But... You know, we've been kind of keeping an eye on it, and it doesn't seem like we're seeing a lot of spamming or anything like that. It seems pretty good. We're pretty happy with it, but let us know, community, if you think... Why?
I haven't played Warmonger for so long. He's so fun.
If I... Takes away really critical for him, so I think that there it's a little bit harder. Or I mean, the stamina unit is pretty good cost on killer.
Oh no, I'm blinded.
Yes, just run, I guess.
Oh, he means when you throw it. Yeah, we could. I mean, maybe we could make one if you throw it and you pick it up right away or something like that.
Oh,
sorry, dude.
I ran right into it.
Okay, we gotta.
He's after me.
Are you blind? No, you're good.
No, I'm not blind.
I gotta not miss my second toss. feel like we're just getting killed one by one, eh?
Hector yeah. Karn asking, is there any plans for a minor character? Yeah, we have a bunch of cool sketches. Jose actually drew a... I think Tony was pushing for a Chinese minor at one point. Right, Tony?
At one point.
At every point. Yeah, there was a ton of sketches. There was a guy who... There was a minor character. Then there was a version of the minor that was like, you know, pickaxe, melee, that kind of stuff. Then there was a version of the minor which was like little nitro, like not TNT. What is it called, Chris? What was the thing called?
Nitro. This.
I think so. Yeah. And it just has little explosions.
Oh, man.
There was a lot of different variations.
Yeah. Don't go that way.
The town butcher, he was a really cool one. So, I mean, there was a lot of really cool concepts that we have sketched out. It all depends. Right now, our priority is just free to play and getting players into the game. If we can get players into the game, we can keep
making. We can do anything.
That's the dream.
She has no stamina.
Hi, gamer husband. I didn't see you in here.
I lost her. Oh, there she is. Damn it!
I'm running away.
Coffin maker.
Sometimes it doesn't say blinded over my head.
What weapon would the coffin maker use?
Oh my god. The coffin.
Hammer.
Hammer? Hammer time?
That's hammer and a chisel. Oh no, it's happening again, Tony. Get me out of here.
She's far away from you.
Okay.
Hey, Umbri, the Umbreon saying, if you make more characters, I will pay for them. Yeah, that's the hope. Is this, so if we can get enough...
Oh my god.
...that are like you, then this thing could work. It would be a beautiful thing. Every month, release a new character.
Oh, I hate you, Matador.
Is shiny. Oh my god. I almost made it to you.
Oh my god.
Gamer husband. Putting in long hours working on Dota 2 esports. Cool, man. Hopefully if this game gets big, you can help us out with some knowledge on that stuff. Coffin as a shield. That's a cool idea.
Chris, do you like the Warmonger Phantom combo? Oh. He got us so upset he left the screen.
Sorry. double Phantom, that was our...
That was it? You want me
that to... was the winning team.
Let's try that again.
So the taunt mechanic we've been looking at, we should talk a little bit about that. That's pretty funny. If you press the button, you're going to commit yourself to 110 frame animation where you're like doing a stupid taunt, like a dance or something. It's almost like a self-stun because you can't get out of it yourself. If you're good enough to pull it off, you know, then the guy's, you got to have some confidence to pull that off. The guy's not going to get in range to attack you.
I saw some of, you showed me some of the stunts. They're pretty awesome. Pretty funny.
Yeah, I have a... Gordo does a little Bollywood kind of shake, and... Zerder's doing some jumping jacks.
He's a workout freak, eh? He does push-ups when he dies. And jumping jacks when he's taunting.
Gamer husband, we were still talking about Secret Ponchos esports on Friday. Yeah, I would love to see that. I think when this game goes free-to-play... I think there's a good chance that we can really get this population boomed. We just have to make a huge event out of it. What we learned from the free week was that, like, the free week was really cool to see so many people coming in when the game was free. And I think, imagine if that was just every week, you know, so.
Oh, people are leaving just to play with us. Don't do that. Just play.
Just play.
Just play. Oh, Chris, what happened to you? Oh, you got pulled.
I tried to merge, but it said full.
Issue.
Darren's also been working hard. He's been rewriting the whole matchmaking order that everything happens in. Yeah, Free Week was good. It exposed a few problems that happen when our game scales up. You know, remember you guys saw the join full problem and stuff? So we're working. But we're probably going to need our community's help before we go free to play. We just want to do as big of a test as we can with getting as many people in. So we'll probably hit you guys up if you're down for it one Saturday morning.
Mm-hmm. Probably make it like a beta branch and we all can hop on and try it out.
Yeah, review scores plummeted. That was so sad because we were up to like 84. But it just was, it was just unfortunate that we had that problem, that netcode problem where friends find friends broke, and almost all of the, it just killed the review score, because that's when instantly such a large volume of people tried it and they saw the problem. And it's funny because even though we fixed the problem within a couple days, you know, people didn't really adjust their reviews or anything like that. So we'll have to come back from that. I think what we'll have to just do is, you know, as people come in and they like the game, now that it's, that stuff's fixed, you know, they'll write reviews. And I think when we go free to play, we just hopefully that one starts off on the right foot. It was really unfortunate that we only discovered that scaling up issue the first day of free to play, and it took a couple days to fix.
It's the pizza guy.
Yeah.
Mr. Domino's.
All right.
Okay.
Deathmatch.
Chris, you lead.
Okay.
We'll confuse them with our
similar appearance.
with our remorse skin.
I only see one. Oh, they're there.
The same.
Voice of all, you're right. Like, we chose to make a high skill cap game, and it definitely scares away new players. You sometimes see angry new players. I think that's just the nature of it, though, and that's okay. They're,
wow. How you doing?
I'm half-life, no stamina.
I'm gonna die, but I almost killed my kid Red.
Okay.
They're both weak.
Hector Concar, my review is thus far 100%. Helpful, nice.
Oh. My god, too close. No mistakes.
The wheelbarrow, that'll save you.
Okay, this is gonna be...
You got this.
It's gonna be awesome. I'm gonna...
Yeah, I can see it happening right now.
Yeah, if anyone...
Yes!
Yes!
If anyone in the chat hasn't dropped us a user review, that would be great. I'd love to get that thing back up to 80 before free to play.
Oh my god, ate all those bullets. I'm not shooting. Oh, they're angry after what happened last match.
I pissed them off.
Yeah.
I'm dead.
Browse, what kind of crossover characters would you like to see? Sackboy?
I think Dante from Devil May Cry would be cool.
Yeah, Gamer's saying we always he feels that we always try and do everything right and get hit with bad luck. Yeah, I think that like a small team like us taking on a game of this kind of scope, there's a lot of risks involved, and I think that kind of increases the chances for bad luck. But I mean, we've been hitting a streak of bad luck, so I'm hoping to get a streak of good luck. That's how it works, right, Chris?
Yeah, I think so. I think I killed you, Tony.
Did you?
Mostly.
Tee-hee. Jerks.
Alright, I'm gonna let you just have a go.
Switch.
See if he can help you.
Alright. Okay, I'm gonna kick Chris
out. If I'm the weak link.
It's probably me, but you guys can't do anything about it. Alright, Chris.
I love.
I mean, oops, I don't see you online.
Oh, coming on right now.
There he is. Yes, you don't want me to be. It was a good combo for killer.
Deserter? Oh, don't start it yet. I'm wolf right now.
Let me know when you're ready. Gamer husband said if he wins the lottery, we'll be in for a share.
Yeah.
What's that American lottery thing that was like $1 billion?
The Powerball.
Well, yeah, I could use $1 billion.
Dude, if we had an investment of like from a big company, that would really help us. We could set up a real little studio and hire more people. That'd be great. All right.
Voice of all, how do I become a friend? And then Hector said, "You got a friend in me." That's so nice.
Tony's working on some skins, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's cool. I'm excited. I saw your concepts. They were really cool.
And no, it's not Nurse Deserter, guys.
And guys, I'm sneaking in some work on Gunslinger. Even though it didn't hit the goal, we're trying to make this guy anyways. Or this girl. Sneaking in some stuff here and there on my weekends.
I don't know these guys. Corrosive DSB, Deathbringer.
Wow.
Two killers. I'm gonna be like a pincushion for knives. Tony's always working like he's a machine. Asian style, man.
We're gonna get it. Okay, let's vote deathmatch next time.
Sure.
I think that works better with the deserter heal.
Knife. Two.
Okay, they're just sitting. Got one with my knife.
Knife.
And I can't hit anybody with my gun.
Healing. Okay, got it off. Last second. Okay, I'm gonna adrenaline run into inside the house. Oh, I got knifed.
She got me.
Okay, got one. What? Alright. I think we're gonna tie though. You gonna lift? Nope.
Oh.
Nope.
Panicked. Okay, that's free view.
Damn it. Okay, healing. Hit the well if you wanna come. Got it. Thank you. Oh, I missed my second shot. Curse it.
Oh no!
Got him!
Yeah, I'm bouncing back. Oh my god. Oh, I got a floating knife on me.
Oh, they got me. Are we down a kill? Are you even enough?
I'll wait.
I'll be down there in a second.
Knife at you. Oh, right at his foot.
You know the worst of the bad luck things? The stupidest one? Is when Lizard Squad hacked PSN when we were free on PSN.
Oh no. Need so much knife. Running back. I'm gonna pop a heal.
Can you pop it?
They're both near like two shots. Oh, one shot. Ugh.
Oh, he got me. Sorry, Tony.
Oh, that guy pushed my snipe shot. Okay, got him. Ah!
Okay, we're two kills down, eh?
Yeah.
Okay, they wasted both their knives.
Oh, I can't even get my sniper. Oops, that was biggy. No.
And I missed that.
Knife. Okay, I'm healing.
No. It's okay.
Too much knives.
We're better deathmatch. We'll find them again. That was so intense.
The Gamer Hassan said, "You could always get YouPorn to invest in you. I hear they're looking for esport teams, and I'm not even joking."
What? We'd like to give you some money, but we just need a few changes.
The U-Porn skin set? Hector said, "I remember that one time I got stuck on a deserter's gun. He impaled me and I got stuck on it. I even spawned on the impale after I died. Then I fell off my chair dying of laughter." Glad you didn't get hurt. I remember that too. That was pretty funny when we were testing it. Alright, deathmatch, right?
Yeah, in the boat. I love deathmatch so much. Okay, let's do saloon deathmatch.
Sir Duke's like, "You porn skins me, guys." No. Oh, hey, Tree.
You guys have any ideas for me for the taunts? Let's see them in the chat. I'd love to get some ideas.
Voice of all us, how do you add guys as a friend? You have to go to Steam and add the Steam account name. So if you want to add me, my name is Casper_SBM. Whoa, what's going on? Two Outlaw Nines? I mean, Warmongers?
Poncho should take his mask off.
It's glue on his face. There will be another mask underneath it. Didn't you guys see the FMV? He took the mask off there.
Finish him.
Yes.
Are we playing?
Yes.
Oh, chat. Sorry, buddy.
Wake up.
I was reading the funny comments.
Gotta get out of here.
Okay, healing. Gotta heal back here.
Good work, buddy.
Come on! Come get some! Shot down a tree.
Is this tree we're fighting here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice work.
Nice one, Tony.
How long should the taunts be? I think the taunt right now is at 110 frames, which is
yeah,
about...
so I set it to the exact length of a stun, so it's kind of like a self-stun. Yeah, so that's basically just under 2 seconds. It's like, bop, bop. That's how long it is. Or, bop.
Totally kill your stamina there, right?
Was that? Yeah.
Did they wipe your stamina? Yeah, you can even evade. Oh my god!
Because they're just so strong, though.
I can do it! I can do it! I did it! Oh my god. Murder. I gotta protect you.
Okay.
We need your DPS. Oh, I hate that.
I'm trying to bait them. There's some warmongers sneaking around on the map.
Are you going to be able to do more than one taunt per character?
I'm going to start with one. I might be able to do more than one, for a couple, at least. Shoot! Sorry, Tony.
Oh, good. It's my fault for being chubby. I'm dead. Oh, nice work. Kid Red, did I fire 7? Did I fire 8? Make my day deserve. It would be funny if some of the taunts are just voice, eh?
Yeah.
They point at the direction and do a voice. What would Warmonger say?
Like on the D-pad or something?
Yeah. What would Warmonger say? If he's taunting somebody. Or what sound would he make?
Say, hello my baby, hello my darling, hello my right hand, yeah. That. Man, this Warmonger's gonna kill me. It's just a matter of time.
The Mad Hatter asks, how do we feel if the taunt attacks? It would be something to increase the time of the taunt, but give a chance for more damage in an interesting way.
Or what if, could we do it so that if you do a taunt and then you...
Oh, you're so dead.
Yeah, no stamina. Good job. Wow, he's really effective against Killer.
Yeah, Tree is very effective against devs.
He's a good tree.
Trish, you want back in?
Sure.
Alright.
So I'm the weak link, eh? You said wants to not play with me anymore. Alright, Chris.
I'm lower my score.
Dun, 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 dun. I am gonna play. I'll play Gordo.
Warmonger can spit on the ground, that's true. He can spit on his hands like a baseball player.
and then throw his
He can do the Babe Ruth like pointing with his club.
That's really funny. Deathmatch or domination.
Like a funny type. It's funny, we're trying to stay true to the characters, so like Kid Red is a little goofy and Gordo's a little goofy. I feel weird making a goofy taunt for someone like Phantom. They probably should get tough taunts.
Maybe he's a really funny guy underneath the mask.
It's Gordo.
The mask keep him skinny?
Yeah.
I like the idea of just them having a cool audio line.
Don't need more than just one. Empty guns.
You can make them read.
It'd have to have a cooldown though. Otherwise it'd be like, want some of this? Want some of this? Want some of this the whole time you're fighting.
I mean, that's pretty
cool. Oh yeah, I forgot Soul Calibur. What? Is that all you got?
Oh hey, Silence. Did I miss anything important? Yes. You miss a lot of important stuff. I have to wait till next week till we talk about it again. Just your
Oh, case. Silence here. Hi, Silence. No, we talked a little bit about our free-to-play goals and you know what we want to avoid when we do free-to-play. I think at this point it's pretty much clear that the only way to kind of move forward boosting the population is either get bought by a $1 million company that pumps a bunch of money into advertising.
And gamer husband wins the lottery.
Gamer husband wins the lotto. That's the second plan. Or free to play is the third plan.
Or if one of us wins the lottery.
Yeah.
The lottery is pretty much the number one plan. Yeah. So everybody buy your tickets.
Raffle.
We should do a Secret Ponchos lottery week where all the players buy a lotto ticket and they split half of it to fund the game if they win. That's what we should do. No, seriously though, the free to play, we're pretty excited about it. We went into detail. We're working hard on how we would build this model and just the things we want to avoid and things we want to do.
Need one more. Join us.
Yeah, Hector, I like the audio.
Mm-hmm. That's a good idea. Well, too bad the Chinese miner isn't in the game. I would love to do his voice.
Another important argument to add the Chinese miner. We have our voice actor already.
Hey!
It's like half the work is done right there.
Hey! Just do that all night. Hey!
Remember the wolf pounds? Oh, how?
Hey, Umbi. Yeah, I remember you from last week. Don't even have a donate button on here. Should we add a donate button? I would take all the money, so I don't think we should add it here.
We could. To become a Twitch partner, you just need 1,000 followers. Oh, wow, we have 1,000 followers.
Mm-hmm. There you have it.
Gene wants to do a voice.
Yeah, we should.
All right, I'm Fatty.
Okay, guys, we'll apply for a Twitch partnership. That's a good idea.
Bordo, eh? Mm-hmm.
Gordo could pluck one of his belly hairs. Gross!
Ow!
Yeah, the taunts are excited. I'm kind of excited about them. It'll add another form of interaction in the game. Oh, Gamer Husband can be a Scotsman.
Ah. I got killed by Jerry. I don't like getting killed by a guy named Jerry. Such a nice name. Ah!
It's a nice throw.
I'm now 100% focused. Oh my god, I missed that. There you go.
You better do an East Indian character then. I'll do the voice.
I think we should get Jose to do Gordo.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Gordo is laugh. Oh.
Oh no. My headphones are dying. Gotta hold them off for a minute.
I hate to break it to you, Gamer Husband, but Apu sounds like a white guy doing an Indian accent.
Oh my god. Jerry. My concierge is called Jerry. Like I'm getting killed by him. Boom. That was nice work by that guy. Okay. You're right there, Chris?
Yeah, I'm just trying to get my headphones plugged in so I don't...
Oh, Renard has an apprentice. So I think something else a free-to-play game needs is a strong friend referral system. That's something we're trying to wrap our heads around how to do it. It feels to me like a multiplayer game. The way it grows is people only play it if their friends are playing. So we gotta find a way to... I mean, that's the good thing about installing a currency or something. This can go.
Oh my god. Kid Red keeps killing me.
Jerry?
Yeah.
Jerry Red.
Silence saying that there's a PS4 tournament tomorrow. Awesome.
Oh, awesome, Silence. Thanks for doing all that stuff for us, eh? It's great that you guys are trying to keep the game alive on there.
There we go. I got Jerry for you. Oh, he left a dynamite for me though.
We're tied, we're good.
Oh. I got stuck in the wall here. Wow, that's pretty good. We're monging.
Yeah, they're both really low. Well, actually, we're monging. It's not that low. Thanks.
Other than the miner, any other character concepts you're excited for? Wow, we did so much exploration. Let's see. We had a really cool butcher character, and he had like a whole bunch of different arsenal of different knives and cleavers and stuff like that. I like that guy a lot.
The Undertaker?
Yeah, it was kind of like a really creepy Undertaker character. There was this hangman peasant who, he's like, they hung him, and he cursed some words before he got hung. And he was an innocent farmer, peasant dude, and the next day he's gone from the thing, and then you can see him walking around with a noose around his neck, gunning down with vengeance. So nobody knows if he's like a ghost or if he's like a, if he just kind of got himself down. That was a cool one. And I liked, we had Madame Triste, she was a favorite. The
Tony.
Dancing saloon.
Oh, sorry. My...
Oh, I was dead. No.
My timing was a little off.
I really like that the knife idea with killers, if it scales to the time that you throw it. That's actually on our list of things to do. But because the knife works as is, where it's a little bit lower priority than, you know, some of the other stuff we've been doing, like just trying to get the some really important features put in. But I think if we ever, once we get those features out of the way, I'd like to go back and make a tweak to Killer's Knife, so if you stun someone from up close, it doesn't do as much time.
Ah, hey Tony, we gotta
get a kill.
Tie this up, yeah.
Okay, get Warmonger. Let's go. Oh, he went back to his.
So Chris, I had a beard this morning and I went to just trim it and I had the wrong thing on my clippers and I went,
we heard.
It was gone. I was like, oh no.
We heard you.
Huh?
We heard you in the bathroom. And I told Tony about at Evo where you got half your face shaved and then Kaylee's razor broke. And you had to do all your interviews facing this way.
Yeah, that was a little funny.
Why is there no female gunslinger?
Oh.
Did you miss that, Gamer Husband, or are you just being silly? I think you probably would have seen it from the 3 week images.
No, I don't think he's seen it.
Oh.
Gamer Husband, that's actually our next character is a female gunslinger.
I'll fire it up.
Tony, has anyone seen it with all the textures and stuff?
Well, I think they've seen it with, I don't know if they've seen the Maya version. Have you guys seen the Maya version?
I think so, we might have seen it.
Let's see it.
Yeah. I'll open it up. Give me a second. So you guys can say something funny to keep people entertained.
Okay. Chris, tell a joke.
Chris, tell a joke.
What do we say that's funny when we can't make fun of Keely anymore?
I know.
No. It's pretty tough streams these days.
Yeah.
It's like when George Bush stopped.
President, yeah.
All the comedy networks.
Peer pressure complete. Give me a second here. I think it's this one.
Yeah, I had to take a little bit of time off the forums this week. It was just getting a little bit too confusing as I was trying to like plot out what I think might be the best route to go. It just kind of got a little too crazy hearing too many different things. I think I needed some time to kind of come up with my own interpretation first, and then I can hit the forums once I kind of understand what I think's best. And then I can like I could compare input against that, but I needed sort of a foundation. But I'm going to do a forum post pretty quick, and then I'm going to kind of go sweep in there and read all the pros and cons everyone, or different ideas everyone has about free-to-play. Oh, okay. So yeah, this is the gunslinger.
This is closer to the final version of the gunslinger. Some speck on her eyeballs.
She looks good.
Yeah, I love the player. Yeah, I like how we do our girls in the game. They all look so badass. They look like we don't go that easy, like, you know, sexy route. But our characters are kind of have that, like, you know, attractiveness. But
scary, they're,
like,
sexy.
Yeah, they're like they're attractive, but they're also very strong and like they could put up a fight easily with these guys, these crazy gunslinger guys.
And she's cool.
Yeah, so the idea, yeah, she did kill all the sheriffs for those badges. So she's like a law hunter.
Well, a bad law hunter.
Yeah. Is she a good person? Well, she's just crazy. I thought all of her guys are just crazy.
No, she's not crazy, but she's definitely... This is a rough time with slavery and stuff like that, and she's definitely wanted, and she's not going to... She's not going to go back. She's not going to go be a slave, so she's going to fight her way. She's going to fight if she has to.
Yep. So, yeah, her model's pretty much ready to go. Need to do gameplay, animation, all that stuff.
Yeah, I started sneaking in some animations. Probably what we'll do with her is, because we didn't hit... I think what we're going to do is, the way we made the free week goals, I think when we go free to play, we should make some free to play goals. And then once the community hits a certain size, we'll release her. And then it'll give the free to play community something to kind of push towards. And then, yeah. And in the meantime, I'm just sneaking some stuff, some content in, so that, and Tony did too, so that we don't have to start from scratch. You know, when the community hits that timeline, it won't take as long to get the character ready.
Mm-hmm. Silence wouldn't mind a fat chick. Gordita?
Hey, Gordita was really cool.
What weapon would Gordita use?
I wouldn't mind having some stocky characters.
Couldn't we just make a skin for Gordo?
A ponytail?
And a bra?
And a bra? And a corset?
Yeah.
Bro.
Hey, Gordo could be a girl. You never know. A female phantom?
I think Gordo's gender is probably...
Gordo with bulls. Fat Archer? That would be hilarious.
I'd love to see Gordo with a little hat.
A little top hat? And a monocle?
Oh, classy Gordo?
Yeah.
Well, this is getting ridiculous, guys. Transmonger skin,
Who are these guys? Jack? Septiceye? Nerdcubed? Are they big YouTubers? The thing, yeah, we need to get, I mean, we're going to try and get YouTubers involved again. Right now, it doesn't make sense to get them involved because right now, if they stream, they're not going to have people to play with. It's going to be a mess. I think the best opportunity we have is as soon as we flip it to be free to play and then there's a player base, that's when we got to get streamers involved again. And but then it's good their viewers can actually watch a game that's free, so it'll be really, there'll be no barrier for their viewers to try the game out themselves and stuff. So that's probably when we're going to do a streamer push. I don't know, we've never had money to pay streamers to do anything. I know Awesome Knots did that. They saved up a bunch of money and they hired Total Biscuit to do a video. Those guys are expensive though, man. It's a cost of like programmer for a whole month or 2 months.
I see these guys again.
Dukes and Co.
I should write those guys though, 32 inches. Yeah, we usually really humbly write the YouTubers.
Grovel a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, it's just like a... yeah, and grovel a little bit and then we reach out that way. Paying them feels a little weird. It feels, but I mean, when you think of it like advertising, it makes sense. Like if you're gonna spend $1,000 on advertising, it might make more sense to spend $1,000 on YouTube. But when you think of it like media, or like, then it feels weird. It feels like you're paying someone to just talk about your game that's good, but. We never wrote those guys. Yeah, sure. You should check out their streams.
Oops. I spawned with the slam. This is a bad combo for picking Gordo.
I think that the pounce is actually pretty good, and a lot of it. Some of the players that come from like the legacy one, and they know how it was before and stuff, feel frustrated with it, but. It depends. Like if you're really used to it playing a certain way and then it goes away, you might not like it. But we find it's a really narrow spectrum of players that think that. But we definitely did we fixed a bunch of bugs with Matador that made her weak. And so she does need to be a little bit stronger. We've been slowly dialing her up and dialing her up. She's starting to feel pretty good now. Yeah, I don't think, we've been actually trying to dial her up in other ways, though, besides just making her pounce free. But yeah, the feedback we've been getting from other players that are, you know, and we look at the data a lot, so I think what we're seeing is she's getting pretty, she's still a little bit underpowered compared to the other outlaws, but I don't think that that move is the best one to change, because it caused we flipped it to stamina for a reason. There's just a lot of stuff you could exploit with that thing.
Oh my god.
So you, Chris. Not being very effective with the Gordo against the Kirit.
Yeah, silence, that's a good idea about consuming the spears. I mean, the main thing is it just needs to become a non-spammable move, and it needs to have a cost, a heavy cost to it. We did our latest revision of the game was we moved the blind from stamina.
Oh, sorry.
That's okay.
From costing stamina to being on a cooldown timer.
I thought you were gonna go get the other guy.
And that seemed to free up stamina quite a bit, so that's another thing to look at. But I'll look at it in more depth when right now our head is just so much into just getting this free-to-play kind of stuff working and getting the player base growing. But I want to kind of circle back to Matador, review the data
from
the previous changes we've made and see how everything's stacking up.
Okay, I'm playing Warmonger again.
Yeah, let me get in the game.
Okay. I suck anyways.
Okay, I'm gonna be Phantom then.
I'm gonna turn down my graphics before I,
Kit Red OP. Blah!
No, just two Kit Red is OP.
No, they had a really cool formation thing kind of going. Like, I know. You pursue one of the other incumbents on you. It's pretty annoying.
Silence, have you tried out the Matador on PC? She's quite a bit different. She's got a lot of different buffs, and she's got some... that thing's on stamina, but try it out. But I'll definitely be circling back to her once we get this free-to-play stuff under control.
Asukai said he's new to the game. Just a question, are there any other game modes other than the team versus team stuff?
All the modes are team-based.
Yeah.
So, other than 1v1. But there is a mode called,
Bossy?
Bossy Leader? Yeah. But nobody plays it anymore, so I forgot what it's called.
Yeah, we have free-for-all. We have a free-for-all mode, too.
Right.
Yeah. In private match, you can set up, there's posse leader, where one of you's a leader, it's still team-based combat, and then there's free-for-all mode, where everyone's for themselves.
Hey, Silence, I stopped using Raycall, because Raycall is actually, the company that does it no longer support North America, so, it's like kind of Russian only. And I stopped using it at least. If you want to talk to me, I think you have me on Skype. So just me or you or anybody. Call us on Skype and we can chat about stuff if you need.
All right, I'm ready to go, Tone.
We're in a pregame.
Oh, okay. Oh yeah, we are. Oh, I'm playing Wi-Fi.
Oh, yeah. What?
Sheesh.
Let me plug in some internet.
Weak link right there. Literally.
Wasn't you, Tony?
Yeah. Huh.
How does my Wi-Fi get blamed for you guys losing matches?
Because you're lagging my Skype. I don't know.
You're going to be so fast after this.
It all me.
Game starting use.
Hold on. Turn off this.
Oh, yeah, there's a group chat, too. Jin was saying you can do us there. Double monger in this kick.
Okay. Wi-Fi's off. Oh my god, it's so fast now.
Oh, you disconnected.
Oh. Can you just still hear me?
Yeah. Oh, you just disconnected.
Your webcam went down for me.
Comfy.
Can still hear you.
Okay, 1v1. Do it.
Yeah, Silence, come on the group chat sometimes and hit us up. Or hit me up on Skype anytime. Wolf's Pounce is garbage. Why put a cooldown on it? Wolf's Pounce doesn't have a cooldown, does it?
No, I think you were talking him.
What's that?
I thought you mentioned something about putting a cooldown. I think he was confused because you were talking about Matador.
Oh, sorry, Pounce. I meant Matador. So, yeah.
Yeah,
Wolf's is fine. Without one. Because she has to charge it.
Right, I took the first guy down one on one. Oh no. Bad. Oh, nice work.
Tony's in a match all by himself?
Yeah.
He's gonna do it.
No, I lost.
Lost.
I got...
Oh, wow. Waited. And Azukai, welcome to the game, too.
In 1v1, Tony suddenly becomes OP. Yeah.
It was the Wi-Fi.
It was the Wi-Fi.
Okay, search me. Add me.
Still waiting for my in-game poker game? Imagine we add that, and that's like the most popular part of Ponchos. People just come on to play poker.
They have 10,000 concurrent players, but nobody's playing the actual game.
They're just playing poker.
I can't find a match!
That Matador. Oh, who's this guy? Director of Tentacles?
Tight spot.
two deaths.
Alright. I'm gonna get ready for this combat. Oh no.
I would love to see game modes which last 20 minutes and not 5 minute rounds. I think if there's more objective based game modes, which we, if we do in the future, we would probably be like around that length. But I think deathmatch usually, it's more like we, the way we design a game is more like kind of like shoot fighter, like fighting games. So it's like around like 5-6 minute matches. But if it's like kind of like more like Team Fortress, objective. Oh, I think I can execute it. You know what? It might be because I'm bad at multitasking. I'm not good in TVTs. Okay.
Wow.
Yeah, got killed.
Just got whooped.
Okay, you just run down.
There was all over me. Sorry, Tony, it's my fault.
It's all good.
Let's pick a brighter level. Can't see with my window open.
My daughters love lucky boxes in Minecraft that can get them. Can we get them in there? I would love a pony. Lucky boxes in SP?
What would they give you?
I guess the gamer husband wants ponies.
Ponies? Coins. Some coin boxes.
Ponies or Tonies? Little Tony comes out. I ran out of tea. Oh, Stukes. Oh no, it's not. It's Renard.
He's gonna win this one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh yeah, vote for a different map though, a bright one. Deathmatch, and let's go pause.
Is that is only one person in the world who wants to ride Tony? And he married her? Only one? Aw. Tony size.
Even she's on the fence about it.
That's what happens when you have kids. Tony size career gigolo. I'll make like the worst gigolo ever. Oh, it's Jerry.
Oh,
yeah. This is your chance for redemption.
My nemesis.
Dash Mida is saying he'd like to see the other characters who are in the match show up at the lobby. Alright. Okay, game plan, Tony.
They have really good cover. Not gonna run it.
I'll email you a song, Tony, and you can go out on one of my new songs.
Ah!
Oh, I died. Sorry, buddy.
Ah.
We're rusty, man. Too much working, none of playing lately.
Yeah, I suck really bad now.
Oh, I'm dead.
I got this.
Nice. Nice work, buddy. Whew. They almost had me halfway through. You saved me. You saved me from my death.
That's what friends do. Man, this guy's cooking that dynamite to the very end. It exploded in the air.
Renard is a TNT expert. Watch out, Infinite.
They're low, let them come to us.
Oh!
Ready to match?
Huh? No, I'm watching you, but it's laggy, so... Or not laggy, but I'm...
Delayed?
Delayed, yeah.
Oh, whoops.
Oh!
No stamina, wait.
It'd be cool to make a mode where you could choose two outlaws too. Kinda like Marvel vs. Capcom.
Oh yeah.
Like pick if Phantom and Gordo, and then when Phantom dies, Gordo comes out, and you get to use your Gordo.
Okay, I'm gonna do my Metaphon shot. Yeah!
Yeah! High five, Tony.
Boom! First win! Yeah!
Took us the whole damn stream.
Yep.
The Wi-Fi.
It was the Wi-Fi.
It was the Wi-Fi. Good game. Alright, you just wanna do a recap?
Sure. Okay, so we've been a little quiet in the forums. We've been working away on a free-to-play model, what it would look like. And, we think this is going to be the best way to build up the player population. So, like we said, we want to do it in a way that's not creepy and classy. So that's our big thing we've been trying to figure out. And how to make sure that it's successful so that if we do it, it just increases the chances that we can keep working on the game. We're going to do a big post soon. So guys, just we appreciate your support and patience while we do this. And yeah, we're committed to just doing whatever it takes to get this game out into as many hands of people as possible. So it's going to be fun. We're going to guys let you know as soon as anything's official. And in the meantime, we might hit you guys up for some more opinions in the chat and stuff like that. If you guys haven't dropped any user reviews, go ahead and do that. We got to get it back up to its 80s true state. Thanks everyone for joining. We'll see you next Saturday. Anything else, Tony?
No, I was going to say we do this every Saturday. So, come by again and play some games. And hopefully we have more info or stuff for you guys.
Cool stuff to show you. We'll show you some of the taunts next week in the stream.
All right.
Okay, bye, guys.
All right, bye.
See ya.
Bye, Chris.
New music time.